President Marcos reappoints cabinet members who were bypassed by the Commission on Appointments last week due to lack of time. Finance Secretary Benjamin Diokno, Public Works Chief Manuel Bonoan, and Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista were among those present at the oath-taking in Malacañang Tuesday morning. Former Chief Justice Lucas Bersamin also took his oath as Marcos's Executive Secretary. Noticeably absent from the event was Press Secretary Trixie Cruz-Angeles, who is rumored to be replaced soon. Information and Communications Secretary Ivan Uy and the President's Chief of Staff Vic Rodriguez were also not included in the list of reappointed cabinet members released by the palace. In other news, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. describes his controversial trip to Singapore during the Formula One Grand Prix as productive. Marcos finally addressed the issue, saying it was the best way to drum up business for the country. He also claimed he met with businessmen who showed they are ready and willing to invest in the Philippines. The president's trip had sparked criticisms, with many calling him out for watching the race instead of attending to areas in the Philippines ravaged by Typhoon Karding. A group of lawyers and deans files a petition for indirect contempt against a former anti-insurgency task force spokesperson Lorraine Badoy before the Supreme Court. This is in connection to her statements against Manila Judge Marlo Magdoza Malagar. Badoy accused the judge of lawyering for the Communist Party of the Philippines, New People's Army, after ruling that rebellion and political crimes are not acts of terrorism. Some of the complainants include former Philippine Bar Association head Rico Domingo and law school dean Soledad Derequito Mawis. They assert red tagging has to stop as it endangers the lives of people. The Philippine Commission on Elections expects the final decision on the proposed postponement of the village and youth council polls to come out in early November. The bill is now up for President Marcos's signature after Congress ratified it last week. Under the proposed measure, the polls will be moved to October 2023 from December this year. But the poll body says its preparations are continuing. It adds it will release election-related guidelines, including those for the filing of certificate of candidacy in the coming days.
Hindi na po namin tatanggapin mm-hmm. ang certificates of candidacy ng kandidato, lalo po sa SK, na hindi po of age o hindi po eksaktong taon. Makikita po namin yon. Ikukumpara namin yung date na nilagay ninyo doon sa date na meron kami sa registration nyo. Kahit doon sa ibang kandidato for barangay, deactivated ka na o talagang hindi ka naman botante para pala ng barangay na ito, hindi rin po namin tatanggapin yung certificates of candidacy. Ay para maiwasan yung napakadaming petition na pinapel sa amin.
Turning now to Hurricane Ian's wrath, the death toll due to the monster storm tops 100. Most of the casualties were from Florida, while 4 deaths were confirmed in North Carolina. The search for survivors continue. Ian made landfall as a catastrophic category for a hurricane in Florida, wiping out homes and flooding seaside communities. Hundreds of thousands of homes still without power nearly a week after the storm pounded the state. U.S. President Joe Biden visits Puerto Rico, an island also reeling from a recent storm. Biden announced a $60 million fund to strengthen storm defenses on the island, including flood barricades and warning systems. Thousands of people on the U.S. territory remain without power 2 weeks after Hurricane Fiona's onslaught. At least 25 people have died due to the storm.
We came here in person to show that we're with you. All of America's with you. As you receive and recover and rebuild, we have to do more. We have to ensure that when the next hurricane strikes, Puerto Rico is ready. We are not leaving here as long as I'm president until everything. I mean this sincerely, until every single thing that we can do is done.